Airhorn wake-up call is maybe the most dreaded sound in camp.
Waking up to an air horn is it's a rude awakening.
And that air horn is just something that I wouldn't ever ask anybody to do.
This is one good thing about being an old guy. You get up early and wake these guys up.
You're going to hear it. I don't care if you're in deep sleep or whatever. I don't care if you got music going, anything. I mean, the air horn is going to wake you up. I think they put it on the door.
I've learned from experience, so I set my alarm at 6:40. So I don't have to wake up to the air horn. It's not the most soothing of wake-up calls, but I guess that's part of the beauty of camp.
The one thing that I always try to do on the first day is really establish the attitude and mindset that you want with the players, so that we can get where we need to go to play winning football in the first game of the season.
First day of camp, just getting ready to crank it back up.
Today sets the entire tone for the entire season, so start strong.
First day back in it. See how it goes.
We're good, man. Ready to go. We can lower that shoulder on somebody. We ain't gonna be in pass, but I might hit somebody anyway.
Hey, first day of the year now. How are we gonna start this thing?
Lieutenant Hutt.
Let's go, guys. Come on. We gotta work today, man. All right, set, go. Slide, slide, slide. There you go.
Come on, line up. Let's go.
Flip it. Nah, don't step forward to do it, and don't backpedal. You're too elongated. You're clear out here like this. I'm reading the quarterback, and then I'm going to backpedal inside out. There you go. There you go.
There we go, Marcel. Nice.
Head around, ball. Good catch.
Hustle up, get in the huddle, let's go, quit walking. Hands inside. Your hands are not inside, he's gonna block you all day. Hands inside, better. If he's gonna go that way, I wanna do this. All right, and I wanna see you do this.
Stand up with more guys on the line. Just go ahead. We make a yellow call, they'll point it that way.
4-yard gain turns into a touchdown. That's the big plays we're talking about. No walking on the field. Let's go.
You know, when you're the boss, you can kind of set the tempo, you know? I tell everybody else they can't walk on the field, but if I get tired, I walk.
Now, Dre, you know I'm working harder than you, and here I am, 58 years old, and not even affected by this because of mental toughness.
I enjoy it, and, you know, I got to keep my old self in shape too.
Whew. It feels about 196.
You know, it doesn't seem that bad out here to me for some reason.
Heat index still 107 Gadsden, 111 in Tuscaloosa.
Heat warning is still in effect as triple digit temperatures are baking much of Alabama.
Really good first day's work. All right, but there's two things. Too many mental errors when we start to get tired. We made more mental errors toward the end of practice. And the second thing is, guys, it's too much negative body language, man.
I'll be honest, it's probably one of the, you know, two or three hardest practices I've ever had here.
I mean, I know it's hot out here.
You know, we kind of have a rule that we don't say hot.
We're actually not supposed to say the H word.
Never that word. That word does not exist here.
All right, but what are you going to think about? What you think creates what? How you feel?
The heat's not that much of a factor. It's the fact that the humidity and the fact that you got helmets on, so that increases, you know, 5-10 degrees or whatever. But it was hectic.
All right, so if you keep telling yourself that, then you're going to feel that way. and it's going to make it harder for you and worse for you.
Because it's got to be hot either way, so you might as well not, you know, zap yourself mentally as to how hot it is.
And then the negative body language basically tells the other guy, what? You're kicking my ass. I'm tired. Come beat me now.
Everybody says, you know, your mind will go for your body will. So, you know, you just got to remind yourself that and keep pushing, keep pushing.
So don't think about how hot it is. Think about getting better. Think about the next rep. Think about playing fast. Think about your technique. Get a break. Get a break.
Jumping in the cold tub, it's a deep burn. It hurts so good.
You can't feel my legs anymore.
The cold tub is both refreshing and painful at the same time. It's something you have to do.
The ice baths are tremendous. Our theory behind it is if we can bring their core temperature down, their body will not have to work as hard to recover. Therefore, they won't be as fatigued, and hopefully they'll be better for the next practice.
1 minute, your body temperature is probably 110 or whatever, and the next minute, you jump in the cold tub, and it's like 50 degrees.
Occasionally, you'll see a lineman or something like that, and you'll see the whole team rally around them and have to pick them up, and it usually takes, you know, 5 or 6 guys to lift them and get them into the training room to get an IV. So the cold tub's a great thing. It's something we just started doing a couple of years ago, and it's definitely helped us out as far as cramps and the recovery is concerned.
Everybody was hungry, everybody was getting after it, everybody was getting to the ball, everybody was trying to do their best to make plays and their ability to make the team better.
You just got to go back, watch film, correct your mistakes, and get ready to go tomorrow.
And they got the poor me's early, some of them, and I know it's difficult, but it's supposed to be difficult, not supposed to be easy.
So press, even if you had to keep it play side and get us 1 yard, we all right. We work this drill every day, all right? 2 minute steps, right?
The best way to play corner against a receiver is I'm standing here, you have to run around me.
Okay, where are you gonna take the ball right here if that happens?
Right through that gap.
You now become the runner.
Well, I think there's obviously things we can improve on, but for the first day, it's a good measuring stick of what we're capable of.
We got a great start. Got a lot of improving to do, but certainly not frustrated with where we are and just continue to work on it.
All right, now listen up. We got a very different workout today, so pay attention. Yeah! We talk about not being satisfied and staying hungry.
How hard are you working?
Let's go to work.
All right.